Hey everyone, assalamu alaikum. So today finally we are going to study about the stages of tooth development. In the last video we had studied on how the dental lamina and the vestibular lamina forms. So if you haven't watched that video, I would highly recommend go check out that video first, because that will clear your concepts on how the development actually started. So in this video we are going to study about the bud stage, the cap stage and the bell stage. So development of tooth is a continuous process. For example, if the tooth is developing and it eventually develops into a tooth like this, the process from here to here, it is a continuous process. It does not stop at any point. But for the purpose of description, we are going to divide the process into some parts, and that is the bud stage, then we have the cap stage, and then we have the bell stage. And the bell stage is also divided into two, the early bell stage and the late bell stage. So these are the morphologic stages. We call it the morphologic stages because this is based on the appearance. Morphologic means appearance. So based on the appearance, for example, if it looks like just a bud, we say it is a bud stage. Then it looks like a cap, so we name it the cap stage. In the bell stage, it looks like a bell. That is why we have divided on the appearance into bud stage, the cap stage and the bell stage. Now let's start with the bud stage first. Bud stage. So in the last video we had studied that how the dental lamina and the vestibular lamina forms. So this was our oral ectoderm. And this was the dental lamina, and this was the vestibular lamina. So vestibular forms the vestibule and dental lamina forms the tooth. So below this we have something which is called the ectomesenchyme, or you can say the connective tissue. So all these areas, they are filled with connective tissue, okay? Now the epithelium of this dental lamina, it is separated from the ectomesenchyme by this basement membrane. So this is our basement membrane, and here we have certain swellings in the basement membrane at 10 points because we have 10 teeth in each arch. So we have round ovoid swellings which arise from the basement membrane at 10 different points, and these points, they correspond to the future positions of deciduous teeth. So one deciduous teeth will be here, another will be here, actually making the arrows in the wrong direction. So one location is here, another location of tooth would be here, and so on. And these points, these are the tooth buds, okay? Now when the development will start, these will start to proliferate more rapidly than the other portions. So they'll start proliferating more rapidly. Now let's take one point into consideration, means we are just talking about one tooth development today. So if this is the point, let's say it has proliferated downward, and now it will look something like this. Beneath this we have this ectomesenchyme, okay? So in the bud stage, the enamel organ consists of peripherally located low columnar cells. So here we have, low columnar cells here. And centrally located polygonal cells. So in the center, we have these polygonal cells. Now one thing to note here is that the ectomesenchyme that surrounds the enamel organ, they condense. So the reason for condensation is that we have increased mitotic activity here in this region, and there is migration of the neural crest cells from adjacent area. So we have migration of the neural crest cells along with the increased mitotic activity, because of which the ectomesenchyme here, it condenses, and this is called as the dental papilla. So this condensation is called dental papilla, and dental papilla forms the dentine in the pulp. So to remember it, D for dentine and P for pulp. So both these structures are formed from the dental papilla. Now there is one more condensation that surrounds the tooth bud and the dental papilla. So it surrounds, a condensation surrounds these two structures, and that is known as the dental sac. So this dental sac will be more pronounced, or it will be more visible when we study about the cap stage and the bell stage. But here in the bud stage, it is just good to know that there is one more condensation that occurs surrounding the dental papilla and the tooth bud, and that is the dental sac. Dental sac. So this was our bud stage. Okay, bud, because we see budding of that point into the underlying ectomesenchyme.